So by this point, you've already seen the thumbnail, you've already seen the video title, and obviously you're interested, so you've already clicked it and started watching. But in case you've gotten to this point and you still have no idea what this video is about, these are 5 quality of life tips to improve your mix it up and streaming life. G'day everyone, it's me, Drew, and look, there's not going to be much preamble for this one. Pretty self-explanatory, so if you do appreciate that, you can always give the video a like and you can always subscribe to the channel to see more appreciations like this in the future. But we're just going to jump straight into it with tip number 1, which is mixing it up your own way. Now, what I mean by mixing it up your own way is when you first install Mix It Up, it won't necessarily look like this. The colors and stuff will be a little bit different. So you can actually, change all the colors and the theming and Mix It Up just to give it that little bit of personal touch to it all. So once you open it up, once you click the gear settings in the top right, you go to themes and colors, then you'll see this little settings here. So you can change the color scheme from blue, you can change it to blue, gray, brown, all these different preset colors from here. You can also change the background color. So this is more of like your light theme and your dark theme. And then there's also a set of full themes. So this kind of reskins it to a certain degree. So you see there's an anniversary one, there's a mixer, a Twitch version, and there's a whole bunch in here. So essentially to find out what each of these look like, you kind of just have to select it and let Mix It Up reload with that installed full theme. But something that is pretty cool, as your friendly Mix It Up ambassador, I will have my own full theme in there probably by the time you're watching this. So that's quite exciting. There you'll see Drew's theme in that list. So if you want to get a bit more Drew in your life, choose that option. And that sounded a bit inappropriate, but we're sticking with it. Anyway. Moving on to tip number 2, you can actually hide the actions within the action builder. So this is something that I know I've encountered a lot, which is a bit annoying. But when you're trying to create a new action or command group or something with a Mix It Up, and you're just trying to find a specific action and you just can't find it for the life of you, even though it's all sorted alphabetically, because it's just a big old list because Mix It Up is such a great and flexible streaming bot. So what you can do within the same settings menu, if you go over to commands, you can see down here, you can hide actions from command editor. So if we scroll down, you can see that they've already done some of this. So whatever you enable, so for example, external program, so this will hide external program within that action list, or IFTTT, because I don't use that service, and a couple other ones, for example, like text-to-speech, I don't use that, Streamlabs, Trovo, a whole bunch of stuff. So you can essentially simplify and filter down that list. So if I quickly show you, if we go to our commands and just pretend to make a new command when it decides to load, new command. If we go to action, that list is actually just that little bit shorter. So it's only for the stuff that's relevant for me. But jumping off tip number 2, tip number 3 is tidy up your Mix It Up because you don't want to be in absolute slobs. What I mean by that is that you can kind of already see it here. There's 2 parts to this one. The first one is use categories, and the second one is use action groups. So talk about categories quickly. So it just makes it that little bit easier. I mean, Mix It Up, it's so flexible. I find myself making so many small things that maybe my viewers don't really interact with or even know, but I just like to make it just because I enjoy it. It's just that little bit easier to make sure that you can kind of find what you're looking for in case, especially if you're on stream and you need to fix something on the fly, that you know exactly where you need to go. So for example, fundamental, I have like set stream title in there. Fundamental chat, I got just an English one, lurk, any support stuff, unlurk. So just those categories in there just to make sure if there's anything, I can just go ahead and find exactly what I need. In terms of with action groups, I think the best example of what benefit action groups have is for your channel point rewards, especially stuff that's a bit more complicated and has quite a lot of actions in it. Action groups just let you edit it all in one place and then trigger it where you need to trigger it. Especially for me, for example, this Nyanket attack one, it's a channel point reward. So if we go into our Twitch channel points, we go to Nyan attack. We edit it, you'll see that essentially within the command editor, it's just going to run this one action group. And then if on my stream deck, which actually I'll just quickly show you rather than talking about it. On my stream deck, if we go into our rewards category, our Nyan attack one, it just calls the same action group. So essentially, if I want to edit anything with that reward, all I have to do is I just go within my action groups, and I can just edit it here. And then no matter how it's being called, how it's being triggered, I know that it will all be updated across everything. just makes it that much more easier to manage. I don't have to worry about different versions or things being out of date. It's all in the one place. And moving on to tip number four, which is don't forget that MixitUp is a Twitch bot, which means that native Twitch commands do work. For your mods in chat that are moderating your stream, they'll probably be using like slash commands every now and then, just a little bit easier, especially if they're kind of doing some other stuff. But don't forget that Twitch can use those slash commands as it can just send a chat message. I think a really good example of this is if we go into our events, and we go into our Twitch events for our channel subscription. If we edit this is going to take a second to load because it does have quite a few actions in there within this chat message. I've got a slash announce command at the front of that. So it means that whenever someone subscribes, that the bot alert that says, hey, someone who has subscribed to the channel is an actual announcement message rather than just any old message in chat. It just makes it that much more highlighted and just, you know, makes it that little bit more special. So don't forget, for essentially not just slash announce, but pretty much all those slash commands within Twitch, that MixitUp can trigger those as well. And now for lucky last, tip number five is don't forget about the MixitUp community, because not just me, but really the rest of them are a bunch of absolute bloody legends. Between the developers, between my other fellow MixitUp ambassadors, and between everyone else out there that uses MixitUp, just the creativity and the smartness that comes from their brains to create the stuff that they think of is absolutely insane. And best of all is that they share it with basically everyone because it's such a lovely community. But two great examples of how great they are is the first one, the Discord server. So there's a videos and tutorials channel as well as a community commands channel. And then the second place is within MixitUp itself, if we go to community commands. So this is kind of like the inbuilt command sharing platform. I think one great community command out there, which is just a great BAU one to do, is not just because it's our good friend Tickens Tom, but the VIP badge channel point reward. So essentially what this is you can create a Twitch channel point reward. So I'm pretty sure his is about 40K channel points that if you redeem it, you can become a VIP. But what this does as well is that it checks if you're already a VIP or not. And if you aren't, it makes you a VIP. And if you are already a VIP, it actually doesn't do anything. I'll just send a message. Look, Mr. Moneybags, throwing channel points around like I don't know a thing, you're already VIP, silly. So we set this up. So this is essentially all automatic. So you can just put that within an action group or within the event. And then it just does it automatically. You don't even have to think about it. Whereas before it was a bit of a manual thing where after every stream or midstream, we'd have to go to your Twitch, create a dashboard and go through all those menus and just be a bit distracted. So the MixitUp community, chef's kiss. But I do hope these tips have been useful for you just to make your life that little bit easier. If you do have any questions about pretty much anything MixitUp, you can always leave a comment in the description down below, or you can even jump to Discord or anything like that. All my social links and everything are in the description as well. So you can always just hassle me at whatever point. I'll get to it as soon as I can. But thank you very much for watching. It's me, Drew, and I'll see you next time. And I just accidentally did finger guns again when I was about to say I'm not going to do finger guns. So, phew. Why did I do that?